It is an opportunity for the Bioenergy Technologies Office to showcase some of our successes over the past year towards research, but we do it at a higher level to engage a broader audience. We have technical conferences where we get into the science. We're celebrating, and it somewhat feels like a celebration of our successes, which I really enjoy, but also the opportunity to bring the policy real time to the audience.
I think it's unique in the sense that it is a very special collection of researchers and technologies for BITO. These are companies that are really poised on the edge of commercialization. It's people right on that cusp, the things that are really just coming into their own are the most exciting to me. The Biomass Conference, as it was called in those days, was just the perfect group of people for that.
There's always new richness every year, and there's evolution of policy and technology, and we bring it together at the conference, at the Nexus. I think that's the feature that keeps coming around again and again, how we need the integration, on how we need the number of perspectives and the different expertise to move this forward.
Another area that we like to bring is to try to get people from the Hill there. When we initiated these conference series, we wanted to bring policy to our stakeholders. And so we've always had the conference in the Washington, D.C. area because we wanted to attempt to get congressmen and senators there, if only for their brief time that they could share information with us. And we have been lucky to see some very important people come past our podium.
It has evolved. I love the fact that the conference is always trying new things. We've had ones where they're really focused on the science and we've brought in different agencies. We always have different degrees of flavor of pulling in, because we're in DC, the weather vane of the politics of the time and where the policy might go.
For me, my favorite part of the annual BITO conference were the sessions that were chaired by Jim Lane. He just gave a very engaging question and answer with a combination of executives from industry and leaders of the various biofuels associations.
I would be remiss if I didn't mention the phenomenal mediating skills of Jim Lane on some of those political panels. Within the bioenergy sector, there are many different interests and there are many different drives to go together to air out those opposed viewpoints. We can be respectful, we can agree to differ, and we can learn from each other and move this forward.
One of the things that I've seen grow since the beginning of the conference is how we're impacting younger people. It's the workforce that's out there right now trying to move the bioeconomy forward. And that might be graduate students through professors and into industry. We've tried to really broaden that by bringing in poster sessions and encouraging younger people. And most importantly, our Bioenergize Me piece, which really gets to high school students. And I enjoy that session a lot. We bring them in and they had an opportunity to think about bioenergy over the course of their studies that year. They develop infographics, which we share with our entire network. And then we give an award to one team who really makes the best mark when it comes to understanding the bioeconomy, bioenergy, and so forth.
High school students coming in, talking about their infographic they've put up, the interaction they have with leaders in the industry, academics, people from government, the national labs, how proud their parents and teachers are, and how they see the future. That's always a joy to see.
When we first started this conference 10 years ago, we were expanding beyond ethanol. So we were really starting to work on our messaging around gasoline, diesel, jet fuels, figuring out how to talk about replacing the whole barrel. The conferences give us both a chance to get that message out, but then also to hear back from our stakeholders about what they think about our new messaging or our shift in focus.
And we're building off so much that has already come. I mean, all the phenomenal work in corn ethanol, the work with biodiesel, looking at biopower, looking at products standalone, and now products that enhance biofuels and going towards advanced biofuels. No single entity or one expert is going to solve this. You need all the experts. You need all the perspectives. And the interchange at the conference, we absolutely need it.
The manufacturing economy is not going to grow a lot of jobs unless we have new products and new technologies implemented. So I think particularly for rural economies, that is a really tremendous positive impact that the BDO office can have.
It ebbs and it flows. And we don't know what's going to happen next when it comes to funding and policy. But we always survive, and we persevere, and we're resilient. And that's what I want to leave as a message for people who are engaged in developing the bioeconomy. Don't give up on it, because one day it'll be here, and you'll be able to look back and say you had something to do with that.
We have to convey those breakthroughs in the open environment. The role of government is to enrich numerous entities with the knowledge and inspire future researchers to go forward and take it even further, and to inspire people to actually come into the field and people wanting to use the products. And that's what we're about.